today on Matters of Fact. Solicitor General Jose Calida, the Philippine government's, quote, principal law officer and legal defender, wants to shut ABS-CBN using a legal tactic he had also used to remove a chief justice in 2018. He won his case before the Supreme Court then, despite widespread concerns that a call warranto petition was not the way to remove an impeachable official. But will he also have his way in his call warranto petition against the largest media network in the Philippines this time? Joining us from our Rockwell studio, Cagayan de Oro Representative Rufus Rodriguez is a former law school dean and one of several congressmen pushing for the renewal of ABS-CBN's franchise. Good morning, sir, and thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Christian. Good morning to your viewers, to our viewers.
Okay. How will this co-warranto petition filed by Solicitor General affect the pending bills for the renewal of ABS-CBN's franchise at the House of Representatives?
It has no effect whatsoever because, first, the Constitution provides for exclusive jurisdiction over the grant of franchises and also over the repeal or alteration or modification of any franchise. It is under Article 12 on the National Economy and Patrimony and in under Section 11 of Article 12. And so clearly the jurisdiction for franchises is lodged with Congress. This act of Solicitor General Calida is not in consonance with the Constitution nor the Rule 66 of the Rules of Court.
And of course, strange things can also happen. But in this case, is this very, very clear that a call warranto petition cannot be used to revoke a license, the franchise of a broadcast company?
Yes. Rule 66 of the Rules of Court states that a call warranto petition can be filed against any person who usurps, intrudes into, or unlawfully holds or exercises public office, position, or franchise. These are for people, persons, who would give the appearance to the public that it is a franchise, but actually has no franchise at all. Now, this is not the situation with the ABS-CBN. It has a valid franchise. That is why this franchise will expire on March 30 if it is not renewed by the House of Representatives. So therefore, the very, very petition filed by Solicitor General Calida is flawed and will be dismissed by the Supreme Court because it is not it is not a question of the ABS-CBN usurping, intruding into, or unlawfully holding a franchise. So not one of the elements is present in this case.
How about the fact that the Solicitor General decided to bring his case before the Supreme Court, citing his complaints regarding supposed violations in that franchise?
These violations, clearly, first, if because he's questioning that there was no NTC approval of this program, one of the programs of the ABS-CBN, then the jurisdiction is with the National Telecommunications Commission to stop them from doing what they're doing on what was not allegedly not approved. So NTC, but clearly ABS-CBN has proven that it has all the permits from the NTC in its other programs and its other companies having these programs. Number two, the other allegation of violation is the Philippine Depository Receipts, PDRs. Now, clearly, PDRs are not ownership. It is a way where foreigners can come in and be able to buy these receipts. That's why these are called receipts, not common stock or not preferred stock. So that is why this particular PDRs likewise had gone through the process of approval from the Securities and Exchange Commission, and likewise from the Philippine Stock Exchange. And so therefore, I don't see really any violation there. If the Solicitor General believes that there's a violation, then he goes to the SEC to be able to have this stop the PDRs or the Philippine Stock Exchange. So okay, these are the proper agencies that he should have filed. But what Solicitor General Calida is doing is he's trying to ask the Supreme Court to cancel the franchise of ABS-CBN. That is where the Supreme Court has no jurisdiction, because cancellation of franchise is included in the wordings of the Constitution under Article 12. It says that the franchise, certificate, or authority to operate of public utilities shall be granted by Congress with the condition, subject to the condition, and these are stated in the Constitution. The conditions are, it is subject to alteration, amendment, or repeal by Congress when common good so requires. Those are the exact words of the Constitution, Christian.
Okay, so that is very clear. But in this case, just to make things even more clear, because the Supreme Court has asked ABS-CBN and ABS-CBN Convergence to comment on the co-warranto petition by the Solicitor General. Some people might think that the Supreme Court was already giving due course to the petition by the Solicitor General. What is the right way of looking at this particular move by the Supreme Court?
It's always a template that when there is a case filed, there is always a notice to the other party to comment. And it always states there without giving due course to this petition. It's always part of any order of the Supreme Court. Mm-hmm. That it is without giving due course, ABS-CBN is now required to file its comment within 10 days.
Because before the Supreme Court can act.
Given due course, not yet, no.
Yeah, because before the Supreme Court can act on this petition or decide not to act on that, it has to listen to the other side.
That's correct. That is always due process. So there will always be the filing is there, and then so the other parties made the comment, and it states in their order to comment without giving due course to this petition. You are now required to answer. That is always the template when there is a case filed in the Supreme Court.
Now, in case the Supreme Court decides to junk this petition by the Solicitor General, can he still go to the SEC to question the PDRs of ABS-CBN Holdings and also go to the NTC for his other complaints?
Yes, there are always the Solicitor General should have properly filed these cases there as far as the NTC permits are concerned, as far as the approval of the SEC and the Philippine Stock Exchange are concerned. And so even if it's dismissed, if this will be dismissed, it will be a dismissal for lack of jurisdiction, and there is no basis in the, it will not be on the merits, because if it will be that discussed, it will be dismissed immediately. It is on the ground that first, the Supreme Court has no jurisdiction. Secondly, the petition has no basis.
Okay.
So that will be the dismissal.
Now, you're one of the congressmen who have filed a bill seeking to renew the franchise of ABS-CBN Corporation for another 25 years. Now, while those bills, at least 11 of them, are still pending, they're not moving so far at the House Committee on Legislative Franchises, here you have the Solicitor General entering the picture and wanting to have the franchise revoked. What message are you getting as one of those who have filed this bill?
We are getting the message that the executive, through the Solicitor General, does not want to follow the separation of powers and would not recognize the Congress the exclusive jurisdiction over franchise. You know, our system of government, we have three great branches of government, co-equal. Now, the Constitution precisely has given the power of franchises, grant, renewal, or repeal to the Congress. And so therefore, Solicitor General Kalida is wrong in usurping the powers of the Congress by trying to go to the Supreme Court to have this franchise revoked, repealed. Now, clearly, repeal of a franchise is within the Congress domain. And that is why that is the message. But we in Congress will not be deterred from this filing. We urge now our leadership, Speaker Cayetano, who has been leading our House very, very well, to now call for the hearing so that we can already have the hearing in the Committee on Legislative Franchise. First, a congressman like me has the right to file bills. Now, it was read on first reading, and then it was referred to the Committee on Legislative Franchise. Now, it is also the right of congressmen that the bills that they have filed, which are now in committees, should likewise be heard. And that is why let us be heard, the authors, and then let us hear the ABS-CBN. And then if Kalida knows really the Constitution, then he should have really filed the case, the complaint, and for the petition for revocation of franchise in Congress, okay, in the Committee of Legislative Affairs. That is where he should have filed his petition for the cancellation.
But you know, Congressman Rufus, that this is not the first time that the Solicitor General has decided to use that quo warranto petition to go against someone. In 2018, the Chief Justice then, Maria Lourdes Serena, was removed through a quo warranto petition that was granted by the Supreme Court. At that time, the same issue also arose in the sense that it was there was an ongoing impeachment case, a live impeachment case before the House of Representatives. But congressmen did not exactly raise a lot of concern with the fact that why would you use this quo warranto petition when in fact there was a pending impeachment case against an impeachable officer. What's the difference today?
Let me explain that. In the case of Chief Justice Sereno, the allegation in the complaint, in the petition, is that she is usurping precisely the office of the Chief Justice because allegedly she did not qualify. There was a question on qualification. That is a proper thing to file in that particular case, although it is my position that even that time, it could have been because the impeachment process has already been conducted in the Congress, in the House, then it should have proceeded. The Supreme Court should not have even also granted that because there's already impeachment. The impeachment is a constitutional power granted to Congress on the sitting executive or the Chief Justice and the justices. And so therefore, in that particular case, if I were asked in my opinion, I believe that the impeachment should have gone on. And that case of Sereno should have been dismissed. But there is also a basis because for the filing, just for the filing, a basis because there is an allegation of usurping, intruding into, unlawfully holding the Chief Justice position because she is not qualified. And there were issues on her being appointed. And so that is a clear, it can be heard by the Supreme Court. But the fact is that there is impeachment, there was impeachment going on. And it's always my position that the Congress should have been allowed to proceed with impeachment. Now, in this case of ABS-CBN, it is not even, there are even no elements for the filing. What I mean from the very, very start, ab initio, there is no basis because in this case, ABS-CBN is not usurping, intruding, or unlawfully holding a franchise because it is holding a valid franchise issued by Congress. That is the difference.
Okay. Now, you said that in this case, in the case of ABS-CBN, in the case of the quo warranto petition filed by the Solicitor General against ABS-CBN, the Solicitor General was usurping the power of Congress to decide on these legislative franchises. Do you also think that the Solicitor General, in the case of the Chief Justice then, was also usurped the power, the responsibility of Congress to impeach an impeachable officer?
Yes, that has been my position. The Supreme Court should not have proceeded with the hearing of Chief Justice Sereno. It should have allowed the impeachment because the impeachment provisions in the Constitution prevails over the rules of court. Even now, in this case also, the Constitution is very clear. The Constitution says franchises issued by Congress, revocation is lodged with the Congress and not with any other body.
Yeah, because there's an impression today that because the Solicitor General had his way in the case of the former Chief Justice, somehow he is trying to use the same tactic once again because he got his way before. So why not try it again using the same quo warranto route? This time to go after a media network.
I believe this time the Supreme Court will act accordingly. in accordance with the Constitution and the rule of law. And that is why I believe that after there is an answer by the ABS-CBN, I believe that the Supreme Court will just throw this to the waste can.
Do you think the lack of sufficient concern raised by a sufficient number of members of the House of Representatives during the time of Sereno somehow, looking back, emboldened the Solicitor General to make use of this co-warranto petition, weird as it may sound to a lot of legal experts, to use this against ABS-CBN this time?
Yes, at the time there was not much, uproar. And also I was not there in that House of Representatives because I had a break for 3 years. But what I'm saying is that what has been done before will be corrected this time. This time, the Supreme Court should give the right to Congress the respect also of an equal branch of government. And that is why we respect the Supreme Court in its rulings, but they have to also respect our powers on franchises, which are clearly included in the Constitution and expressly stated.
Okay. Now, talking about the calendar, is there sufficient time for the House to actually decide on this franchise renewal petitions or bills, given this tight calendar that you have before you go on break? Because the franchise will expire on March 30.
And our session end on March 11. So that is the reckoning point as far as Congress is concerned. And that is why we are really very pressed for time. But there's still time. If the leadership would call for a hearing on Monday, because we have a three-day notice rule, there has been no notice for this week. And our last session this week will be today, Wednesday. So we have to have a notice given out today or tomorrow, Thursday, so that we can hear on Monday. And if we do hear it on Monday, there is a still time, because we can have a full-day discussion hearing in the committee, and it can be brought to the plenary, and there can be also faster debates in the plenary. Yes, we can still have that if there will be a hearing next week on Monday. But Monday will only be 9 days, will only be 3 weeks before March 11. And so therefore, we have very few days left in the session days.
Okay, now we're hearing a lot of reasons coming from the House leadership when it comes to the inaction on the pending bills seeking to renew the franchise of ABS-CBN. Some of them were filed as early as last year. Why were they not moving? Why were they languishing at the House Legislative Franchises Committee?
I've talked with the chair, my good friend, Congressman, Chairman of the Committee on Legislative Franchises, Chicoy Alvarez. And he always tells me that wala pang clearance at us. In exact words, wala pang clearance at us. So that is the reason why he's restrained from hearing this bills renewing the 25 years the ABS-CBN franchise.
Okay, what does that mean? Wala pang clearance sa itaas. Was he referring to the leadership of the House of Representatives, or was he referring to someone much higher outside of Congress?
No, I refer to the Speaker of the House, Speaker Cayetano. That is the he is the one that will be very, very crucial in urging committees to call hearings.
Yes. And did you also get any other explanation on why someone up there at the House of Representatives was not yet giving clearance for the Committee on Legislative Franchises to proceed?
I don't want to speculate, but the fact is that there has been no hearing, and that means that there is no clearance from above.
Yeah, because I was looking at the statement issued yesterday by House Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano. He was mentioning the guidance coming from the president when it comes to ensuring free expression or freedom of the press under this regime. But we know the realities in politics here. Just to be honest about this, this is the elephant in the room, basically. So the president has been attacking ABS-CBN. Do you think that was actually the big factor why these bills are not moving?
Well, yes, definitely. The president has also all the right to come out with his experience with ABS-CBN. It happened that some of his ads were not aired, despite the fact that he paid. Now, the reason for this, as I have also gathered, is that when these ads were placed on May 2, it was only 8 days before May 10, the last day of airing ads, and there's a queuing system. But whatever it is, the president has this experience. But I believe that the higher concerns and the higher interest of our country is to be able to protect the freedom of the press that is also provided in our Constitution. Article 3 on the Bill of Rights provides on Section 4 that we assured that there should be no law abridging the freedom of the press expression and the freedom of expression. Now, precisely, when you cut the franchise of you or you do not renew the franchise on the ABS-CBN, it is an assault on press freedom and the right of expression. That is why I filed this bill to renew it, because I am always for the protection and the upholding of the freedom of the press and the right of expression.
Okay, very briefly, Congressman Rufus. Number one, final two questions. What usually constitutes the revocation? What could lead to revocation of a broadcast station's franchise?
Well, if it's revoked or it will not be renewed on March 30, then it ceases operation.
Now, what reason usually, what is the reason that is compelling enough for Congress not to grant a franchise?
Not to grant the franchise?
Yeah.
There is no compelling reason at all. There's nothing. There's no reason why not to grant the extension of the franchise. And that is why 11 of us have filed bills, and there are many also co-authors. And that is why I believe that it is the sentiment of the House to support the Constitution, uphold the Constitution by renewing it. It's just a matter, it's just a problem of the fact that there is no hearing. But can you imagine if we close the biggest station, television and media outfit in the Philippines? Can you imagine that what has been brought to our people also abroad, not only here, by the progress of ABS-CBN, gives information and entertainment all over the world? And can you just imagine the effect of closure to the more than 11,000 employees of the ABS-CBN? Cagayan de Oro hosts the ABS-CBN, and we have workers there who are working with ABS-CBN, and the cameramen, our field reporters, our anchors, our talent. So all of them, including those working in Cagayan de Oro, will have no more jobs. And so really, there has to really be a renewal of the ABS-CBN on these grounds.
Okay, finally, Congressman Rufus, do you honestly think that Malacanang, the president, had nothing to do with the co-warrant petition filed by the Solicitor General, given that the Solgen is the lawyer of the Philippine government?
Well, let us go to what the spokesman said. And spokesman Attorney Salvador Panelo has said that the president does not know about this. Let us leave that as that, so that we will not be able to complicate matters.
Okay, thank you very much for joining us this morning, Congressman Rufus Rodriguez.
Thank you very much, Christian.